AI. Some of you call it a hype and a buzzword. Some of you call it the end of the world. But no matter what you call it, I'm 100% sure that AI could actually be useful to you in one way or another. And so let me show you 10 of the most useful and productivity increasing AI video editing tools in CapCut so that you know they exist and so that you can start using them, you know, before AI destroys the world. This might be the last video you'll ever see. And just so you know, some of these features are free, some of them are only available in CapCut Pro, and as usual, I'm using CapCut for desktop, but there's also an online version and a mobile app. Okay, let's do it. And let's start with one of the most boring and time-consuming tasks there is. Writing a script. Black. I mean, it's not black anymore, because now CapCut will actually write a script for you. All you need to do is give it a prompt. Let me show you. So, for example, something simple. How does a camera work? First, you have to type a slash, then how does a camera work, and then just hit generate, and boom, a script for your video. Now, guys, of course, it's AI and it's not perfect, so always double check the info that you get from the AI. And also, I'm showing you this feature now in the online editor because they're still rolling it out in the desktop version. And, you know, people barely know that Belgium exists, so yeah, I can't use it here yet. But it will come. Anyway, and then once you have your script, you can actually take it a step further if you want. And let CapCut generate a video based on that script. All you have to do now is hit Use Script, select an aspect ratio and a voice, and generate video. You can then choose custom or smart, but of course I'm gonna go for smart generation now. And there you go, a simple video with voiceover. Now, you could use it just like that if you want, but I think it's always a better idea to hit edit and then edit the video some more yourself. Add some extra footage, some extra, you know, whatever, to make it a little bit more personal, to make it your style. But I mean, you can do whatever you want, of course. Auto captions is probably one of the most well-known AI features, and again, it helps you with a boring and time-consuming task, writing captions. A few years ago, writing captions for a video, especially a long video, wow, horrible. I still have PTSD, post-traumatic script disorder. But now, just go to captions, one click, and I mean, you can even choose different languages if you have the pro version, and done. And then of course you can edit the generated captions, add animations, whatever you want. Doesn't get any easier than that. Yeah, so like, I mean, filler words and pauses. This feature will identify them for you if you hit this icon right here. And as you can see, it's a pro feature. And then once it has identified all the filler words and pauses, if you want, you can remove them with one click. Yeah, so like easy. This is one of my favorite features. So let's say you're making a video and you need some footage of a camera. So some B-roll of a camera because you're explaining something that has to do with cameras, for example. Well, if you're lucky, you have all your footage organized, but even then, like, you still have to go look and find the right clip, right? But Smart Search will find what you're looking for automatically based on image, but also speech. And it will even give you timestamps to show you where in a certain clip you have to look. Let me just show you. So all you need to do is type in camera, for example, and then Smart Search will find all the video clips containing the image of a camera. And it will tell you exactly where to look. This will 100% be super useful to a lot of you. Split Scene will automatically detect edit points in a clip and then make cuts based on those edit points. So let's say you have one long video clip with different scenes. Well, just select that clip, hit Split Scene, and then CapCut will detect where the cuts are and also make them for you. So split the clip so that you can then use it for another project, for example. I had to do this manually a few times and I can tell you, no fun. This one I don't use because obviously I'm perfect, obviously. But it's there if you need it. Enhance will automatically detect faces throughout your video and then you can apply enhancements to those faces. You can find it here, enhance, and then it's super simple. Just select an enhancement, some basic smoothening of the face, for example, or you can even change the way your jaw or cheeks look, or someone's whole body. And there's even makeup. Yeah, there's makeup. AutoAdjust will automatically correct contrast, color, and exposure based on the information it gets from your original footage. So, for example, you have a bunch of different clips and they don't match. Of course, you don't want to adjust every clip manually because you're lazy. Just check AutoAdjust here in Adjustment, and if it's too much, if it adjusted too much, just lower the strength. And pro tip, after you use AutoAdjust, check all your footage to see if there's nothing weird going on. You know, it's not perfect. Let's say you're editing an HD or Ultra HD video, but you have some low resolution footage, 720 for example. Well, CapCut can enhance that 720 footage to make it match the Ultra HD or HD footage better. And you can find it here. It's super simple. No complicated menus, just select what quality you need and you're done. Now, of course, don't expect CapCut to magically transform 720 footage into perfect Ultra HD. It doesn't work like that. No software can do that. Have realistic expectations, okay? Okay. Sometimes you get some flickering in your footage because the lights are doing weird, or maybe there's a lot of noise because your camera can't handle low light very well. So then in the same menu, you can also reduce noise or flickering. Super simple. And that's it, 10 AI features in CapCut. Now, of course you don't need all of them. It depends on what kind of creator you are, but at least one of these will probably be useful to you, right? Yeah, thought so. Okay, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.